Hello, everyone, and welcome into this edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Scott Klatskin with 2021 CAA Coach of the Year, Natasha Adair. And Coach, you bring just such a positive energy to every room that you step in. So I appreciate you giving us some of your time. How you been? How's the summer going so far?
Oh, it's great. It's great. What summer? Right? Do we have summer,
yeah.
Scott? No. It's great. I'm sitting in here and just you talk about energy. Well, that energy comes from everyone else around me. It comes from being in the Whitney. It comes from just my student athletes. The energy is contagious around here, and especially right now. And so really excited that we are able to sit here, right, in this room to have this conversation. Because again, you go back and we weren't able to do so. So, you know, I want to start by saying thank you and hope that you're doing well, your family's doing well, but just really excited about what's to come.
You mentioned where we're sitting, the Whitney Athletic Center. Now, basketball has had some pretty nice facilities already, but to add this right across the street from the Bob Carpenter Center, how has this positively impacted your program?
It's a game changer. I mean, when you think about what the Whitney does for our student athletes, you know, what it does for our university, our community, just elite, if there's a word that comes to mind, it's a game changer to be able to walk recruits, you know, in that front door and talk about all the resources in this building, 90,000 square feet of just pure excellence, you know, from peak performance, from health and wellness. You know, you go into the weight room again, which we call, it's an NFL weight room, if you will, you know. But just the players are very proud. This is what they call home. And this is an investment that from the top down, from President Asanas to Chrissy Raywalk, they talked about these things. They talked about, and they actually promised these things. And to be able to deliver in such a way where our student athletes, they will be forever proud of this. Not in our current student athletes, our alums, everyone can really be proud of such a facility. But, you know, first level, you have so many resources, and you see our student athletes walking around, and there's health and wellness, right? There's nutrition. You go into the training room, and again, this is state of the art. All of preventative care measures and then recovery measures and you know, God forbid if someone does get hurt, you feel good going in there that you have all of the equipment, the training, the education behind it, science, Sparta. I mean, I can go on and on all of the things, but then I'd be remiss if I didn't come up to the second floor and just talk about the academic excellence. You know, you have academic enrichment, you have career prep, career readiness, and so this is the holistic approach to the student athlete. We talk about the Blue Hen experience. We talk about the student athlete, you know, welfare and well-being. But it's all on the pillars of our Blue program, building leaders, utilizing education. And so the Whitney, it changes everything that we do. It just puts us in a different, I just say it just puts us, it raises the level. It raises it athletically. It raises the expectations. And when we go out, when we step on the court, we step on the fields, we know we're prepared academically, athletically, and
now and even for future.
It really is phenomenal, and the way it's impacting now, and we're going to see it in the future as well with the Blue Hens teams. I do want to go backwards, though, and talk a little bit about your 2020-21 season. What a journey that was. I will say, though, both sides of basketball, women's and men's teams, you were the only one that played 18 conference games. You were the regular season champions in those 18 games. How were you able to navigate the season? And then what did you learn about yourself, your staff, and your players?
Well, the way we were able to navigate is the people behind the scenes. You know, I won't take a lot of that credit. We have so many special people, our support staff, you know, from Chrissy to you know, JVS to, again, you go through Mel Johnson, our athletic trainer, Rich Levy, you know, strength and conditioning, James Coleman, academic enrichment. I mean, we're one. It's a one-team mindset here. And obviously, there were so many things that were unknown in very uncertain times. And, you know, I think at that point, the first thing when you really don't know, it's no different than game day, right? To a certain degree, you have to prepare your student athletes for the next play. You have to call a timeout and you have to be able to adjust. And so we did that. And our kids were following our lead, true enough, but they've been empowered. They've been empowered. This is a program that is player-led, coach-supported. And so they know that they have their voice. They know that they're strong in numbers. And so with the right guidance, with the people behind us kind of supporting us and leading the way, again, Melanie Johnson was the real MVP in this as our trainer. I mean, she was on top of all of the COVID protocols, what we needed to do. Her communication was second to none. I mean, we felt like ahead. And I think that just trickles down from everyone kind of in her area leading the way as well. And so Dan Watts and his crew, but again, it trickles down. But our players, once they knew kind of what was ahead of them and they knew the protocols, they knew kind of the do's and don'ts and the restrictions and what they could do, they came together and they said, you know, we want to play. Every day they talked about what they want to play. And so they were able to eat together. They were able to spend time together. And I think that's where the closeness, right? We were having courageous conversations around what was going on in the world with social injustice and things of that nature. But then we were also having conversations about what people were feeling during this time. And I think that brought the closeness. We're already close, but I think when you're forced to just spend so much time together, I think that's what did it.
You advance to the CAA championship game, and then that run in the WNIT all the way to Memphis. So with such a successful 2021 season and a unique season as it was, how do you build off of that momentum with a lot of players that are returning? How do you build off of that and say, we did well last season, let's continue?
Well, you know me, last season's over, right, as I tell them. But we remind them of how focused we were. You know, we pretty much have the majority of the team back, the core group of the team. And so they have unfinished business. You know, they were very proud of what we were able to do, you know, last season, but there's more. And they know, you know, our motto is actions over words. You know, it's a group that's not gonna do a whole lot of talking. They just wanna show. But we've added elite, right, to it. And so to be elite, you have to do more. And everyone has to commit to doing just a little bit more. And so that's our focus right now. You know, there are some things that we've talked about as a team and as a group on what's going to be the difference. You know, we don't have to reinvent this wheel. We have really good veteran leadership for sure. But there are just some little intangibles that we have to take care of just to be consistent in some areas and just get to where we want to be. But the drive, the discipline, the competitiveness, the hunger, that's there with this group. And you know, I'm just excited. I come in every day. I mean, we're able with summer access to be able to be in the gym with them, you know, 4 hours. And I'm telling you, I have to pull them back a little bit. I'm like, wait a minute, you know, we have to be ready in November. But they're so focused on just being better. And as long as we keep it one game at a time, don't get too far ahead of ourselves, but just the competitive spirit in the gym, the competitive energy, the discipline that this group has, you know, it's going to be one fun season, I'm telling you.
It really is. And I think back to last season when I had the ability to talk to you a little bit, chat before the season started. And one thing you said about the team was, Scott, this team can score the basketball. And there was a lot of new players on the team, and certainly ones that I hadn't seen play in a Delaware uniform before. Then you go out and you score 111 points in your first game, 85 in game two, 93 in your third game. And I was like, okay, all right. Coach knows what she's talking about. She knows about her team and her team's capabilities. So what do we need to know about this team coming up? What are you excited about the most?
We're going to score even more. I'm going to tell you that. And that was one thing that we talked about statistically, some things that we need to do. And again, we play fast. You know that. We're not going to slow down. We're still going to be transition-based. We finished number one in the country in offensive rebounds. You know, and again, we're not the tallest team in the country, but we are the team with the biggest heart. And so you're going to see with just some new additions, you know, we're going to get more rebounds. We're going to score and we're going to take the shots that we need to take, you know. And I just felt like in moments, you know, certain shots that we got, we have to make them because that's going to be the difference. And so that's what we're really focused on in this offseason, more fundamentals, you know, just more technique. And not so much pounding up and down, but just really coming in the gym and more skill work, more individual work, individual growth and development, because everything else, the culture of the team, right, the standards of the team are already set. And so now this is the time, especially in the summer, for everyone's individual skill set to improve. And so that's what we're really excited about. But, you know, we were at 75 points. You can add about 10 more to that, because we're gonna score. Mark my words.
I think we're gonna see the ticket sales.
Yeah, please, absolutely. We're gonna play fast, but we're gonna play smart. And I think, you know, we're gonna play on both sides of the ball, but we're gonna defend, we're gonna rebound, and we're gonna run.
It was an exciting team last year, and we can't wait to see more of it. Now, last season, when I spoke to you about your team, your team was picked sixth in the CAA.
I know.
And so you knew how good your team was. Maybe the media members, the other coaches weren't quite as sure. You're not going to sneak up on anybody this season.
So I'll
end with this one.
Yes.
Obviously, the expectations, the goals are high. Mm-hmm. What are those goals for this season?
Same. You know, I came here to win championships, and the players that we've recruited are here for the same reasons. And so that's the goal. Again, we were regular season champions, and we're very proud of that, but we're not done. And so we have to continue getting better, continue improving. But you're going to see elite effort on both sides of the ball for 40 plus minutes, night in and night out. And we're going to keep our foot on the gas. This is a team that's going to be fun to watch. This is a team, again, you will not, don't blink, because you're going to miss something. But you're going to see a sisterhood. You're going to see that energy. You're going to see that excitement. You're going to see players getting, you know, celebrating their sisters and their teammates, you know, for good work, for good plays, for hard work. We're going to do it together, and we're going to have a whole lot of fun.
I'm looking forward to November already. Coach Adair, thank you so much for your time, and thanks so much for being a part of Coach's Corner.
Thank you, Scott.